as in Landon Burton. McKenzie
We started a brotherhood, really, and we've had a lot of memorable experiences together, some good and some bad. But there's not too many people that I've met that have really been as kind and as caring as what Lucas can be. And I know that no matter where we are in life, that near or far, we're always gonna be brothers. And I would like to propose a toast. Would be the many happy and wonderful years for Lucas and McKenzie.
Making your journey out here. When McKenzie first asked me to be your maid of honor, I said no. Because most of you know me, I prefer my old white headband, jeans, a t-shirt, and a dick. And wait. Alright, any day over this dress, but McKenzie gets what McKenzie wants. Finally, after having to get over the fact that I would have to, of course, wear a dress, I felt very delighted because as the big day approached, I forgot that I would be doing a speech. Being the shy one and absolutely hate talking in front of groups of people, I was trying to think of ways to get out of it again. And boy, let me tell you, I got clammy just thinking about it. But saying no to McKenzie isn't an option. So I started thinking and thinking and thinking about what to talk about, and the only thing I could think about at first was how much we fought growing up. I mean, we had to share a room for like 16 years until I eventually kicked her out of our room into the basement because she is so messy. I mean, it was like hoarders buried alive down there. I felt so bad for Lucas to have to see the basement and thought he would run as soon as he saw it because that's how bad it was. But thankfully, he didn't. Looking back past all the fighting in the messing room, I saw her as my second mother, the one to always pick me up if we fell, help us with our homework even if it was 2 a.m., and the biggest supporter at every single sporting event of ours that Mom and Dad couldn't make it to. I wouldn't trade those memories for anything. To this day, McKenzie is the only person I know that can make me laugh so hard it hurts because of all the stupid stuff we do. And I can honestly say I wouldn't be half the person I am today if I didn't have a big sister like her to look up to. And I'm proud to call you my big sister. As for Lucas, I never knew Lucas before he started dating my sister, so I can't tell you embarrassing stories about him. But I can tell you that I think he's perfect for my sister. I heard that girls tend to look for someone like their father, and I think McKenzie has done a perfect job. Lucas is very laid back, easy to talk to, likes to fish, and likes to pick on McKenzie.
Yes!
We are happy to welcome Lucas into our family. We know he's made for us, and I hope we're made for him. I'm excited to have another brother, but I hope Lucas is mentally, physically, and emotionally prepared to have us as his family. Alright, as I was thinking some more, I thought about words of advice that I'd like to give the newlyweds. Lucas, don't ever judge McKenzie because you are one of them, the choices she made. Do everything McKenzie says because McKenzie gets what McKenzie wants. Lucas, always cook the meals unless you want the house burnt down. Alright, separately you two are special and remarkable people, but together you are complete. As you sit side by side through the roller coaster of life, remember to scream through the peaks, hold hands through the dips, laugh through the loops, and enjoy every twist and turn. For the ride is much better when you share it together. My greatest wishes for McKenzie and Lucas are that they are continued loving friendship and partnership, that they enjoy success and laughter, that they are blessed with children, or not, that they always see and talk with heart. So please raise your glasses while I toast my sister and brother-in-law.
Please.
Together each day, take each day together and cherish it. Yeah. Love one another and stand together. Take time to listen to one another. Put your love and family first, your jobs and hobbies second. May your love be like the wind, strong enough to move the clouds, soft enough to never hurt, but always never ending. So here's to love, laughter, and happily ever after. Cheers.
All right, I'm the obnoxious one. My name is Amber, and I'm a friend of the couple. I've known Lucas for probably about 6 years, and I've known McKenzie for about 3 years. I'd like to start off by thanking the parents for raising such wonderful individuals. Because of Lucas, McKenzie and I have become the best of friends. Some people think we're sisters. Every now and then you can catch Lucas and my husband Kurt saying, "I can't believe you guys are this close and you do these weird things." But we kindly remind him it's all his fault. Lucas and McKenzie, I'm glad you both have chosen each other because you both put up with each other's issues and some things I can't say out loud. Yes, McKenzie, it's about time your last name's shorter because I hate spelling Eisentrager. Alrighty, let's raise a toast to the bride and groom.
A friend of the bride. I have known this girl since kindergarten, and I'm so happy she is now finally married. To make it short and sweet, I have one memory with McKenzie, and that is going fishing with her, where we would catch a fish, and either of us would take the fish off, and we would scroll through our cell phones trying to find someone to come take our fish off. So Lucas, please be our new guy and take our fish off.
All right, my name is Patricia Hernandez, and I really was unprepared for this. I'm going to be completely honest. I have no idea what I'm going to say, but I can say I'm emotional, and this might end up in a train wreck. But, Kinsey, I love you, and I've been here for you since we were young. I was the person who got, we were actually each other's, like, you know, I would make the ideas and she would agree with it, and then she would think it was a good idea and I would do it. So we had these terrible ideas, really, that we thought were amazing, but we did. Oh, okay. Sorry. But anyways, I cannot express to you, Lucas, how amazing this woman is. She really is the most kind-hearted. She will put your feelings first before she puts her own. And sometimes she won't even realize how she's feeling until your feelings are dealt with, because that's what kind of person that she is, and she's always been that person. And you are very, very, very lucky to have this amazing woman in your life. And if you ever need a reminder, just call me, because trust me, she's bailed me out of the emotional stress that I've had over my past 24 years of life. And yeah, she's amazing, and you are the most amazing man in the world to have this woman sitting next to you. So yeah, that's all.
I am Liz Wagner, soon to be Cottle in 3 weeks. Woo! I'm a friend of the bride since we were in high school. We played volleyball and softball together. So many memories to them. Okay. She is the sweetest girl ever. I am so emotional. Seriously, we have so many good times together between just back row jamming in my car. She was always there for me, no matter what. And I just want to wish them a long, happy marriage.
Hi, my name's Denny, and I'm McKenzie's cousin. First of all, I would like to congratulate you. Z, you have always been my role model. There hasn't been a time that I haven't wanted to be just like you. And Lucas, the first time I met you, I knew you were perfect for Z. You just seem to fit in perfectly with our family. Both of you have already been through so much together, and I wish you a life full of love and happiness.
I would just like to say, say congratulations to Lucas and McKenzie, and I hope you guys enjoy your long walks at Walmart in every single aisle.
You guys didn't have me up here for nothing, right?
Right! You're fired.
Sing it.
I'm fired?
Sing it.
Oh, somebody want to replace me then? Anybody? Well, Lucas, you did find yourself a girl, right? After all these years, you're like, I'm just giving up. I can't do this no more. Well, ever since you met McKenzie, every day I've seen you, you've always had a bright smile on your face. You've enjoyed it every single day of being with her, no matter if she calls you 25 times a day, chewing your ass. I don't care, you're always all like, well, I'm gonna go home. I've got a loved one there. Always hanging out with you guys, it's always been a blast, even though you guys always classify me as the one that always makes bad decisions.
Woo, Kyle!
But you guys shake your heads at me because you always know we always have a good time, right?
Right.
Friend Fridays, yes. We need to continue them again. All I have to say is love each other no matter what you guys do, highs and mouths, peaks and lows. Always love each other no matter what might come across your path because you know you always got each other to get each other together.
I'm Landon, I'm Lucas' older brother. His only. I really don't know what to say, but growing up with him, yeah, we had our times like everyone else, we don't get along. But I still think, you know, over the few years after he met McKenzie, he slowed down. And I think we grew up with the three of each other. And just get used to it, you're never right. And it's yes, dear.
Hello. All right. McCade and I are just sitting over here listening to all of what you girls said and totally wrong. So every time you give her a compliment, Cade and I just chuckle. Because Lucas, woohoo, you are in for a treat, buddy.
Wow.
You are a brave soul. Congrats. Good luck. And hopefully many, many more years.
My name is McCade. I am brother of McKenzie and apparently Lucas now. I'm just saying sorry because, Lucas, you have a lot more wrestling meets to sit through and football. Yeah. Congrats, I love you guys.
I'm the father of McKenzie. We've known Lucas since a couple weeks after they got together secretly. But we figured it out really fast. I would like to thank everybody for coming. Especially all you guys here. Cade and Mason don't always know what they're talking about.
That's fine.
Lucas has been a big brother to my kids since we've known him. McKenzie's always been kind of my go-to. Tiff and I, every time we needed something, you know. She was the oldest, so sometimes she thought she got the shaft, but she didn't really get the shaft. She was kind of our go-to girl. She helped a lot with our young kids. And the turnout tonight, you know, is great. It's the prime example of what kind of people you guys are. Bunch of comedians back here, but I'm trying to make it through it, trust me.
Don't you try, boy.
But there's a lot of special people that we need to thank. My family, Tiff's family.
Thank you.
They keep asking me at the top here.
No.
So as soon as I get done here, a lot of people tell me I ramble a lot, but I really don't. But I'd just like to thank everybody for coming. It's been a big day. It's been a big day for us. I'd like to thank everybody from our families, especially all of our friends. Jack Kobe and his crew for the food. Taylor Pro, LB back there serving at the bar. April for taking pictures, but the DJ, we couldn't make this happen without everybody involved, and if I stand up here too long, I probably can't talk anymore, so thank you everybody. The DJ's going to get started here before too long, and what? And then now I got to bring the microphone over here. I'm done. Out.
Okay. Hi everyone, we would just like to thank everyone that came today to help celebrate this day with us. I've been looking forward to this day for a long time, and we're so happy that it's finally here and we can continue on as husband and wife now. Again, like my dad said, we just like to thank everyone who helped us.
She's a fighter when she's mad, and she's a lover.